ball at the 10-yard line.
Let's go! Let's take it!
And their tight end to the left. Henry with the carry. Nice tackle.
3 yard pickup on the play. Second down. 7 yards to go.
It's second and about 7 yards. They're going with two tight ends.
Run to the outside made sense. It made so much sense that the defense anticipated, got there first, and shellacked him.
Third and 10.
Coming up.
Oh, nice pass, but they're just shy of the markers, Dan. Let's see what they decide to do here.
Henson will punt it away after a 3-and-out. Nice punt. Stewart fields this one.
Time they had the ball, they were stopped on a big fourth down play. Let's see if they can punch through this time.
First and 10.
Watch the clock. Hurry, hurry.
Five, Brady from the gun. Throws.
He connects with his receiver with ease, Dan. He sees his man and then airs it out for the completion.
Yeah, they are in sync. They're able to depend on each other as the play unfolds.
They actually look like Backstreet Boys to me.
I don't follow that. All on the 39. Brady from shotgun. Got way back. Ingram was the intended receiver, incomplete.
Tom Brady had that receiver in his sights, but he didn't lead him well enough.
Right.
Ball at the 39-yard line.
Keep them where they are. Walk them off. Rip.
Brady from the gun. Keeps dropping back. Throws.
Some success with their air attack this drive, Dan.
We've reached the two-minute warning. Ball on the 14. Looks like they're going with the shotgun. Brady from shotgun.
This team has got its body in the way of that one, Dan. It's all about clogging up the passing lanes. You can't coach that.
Right.
Second and 10.
Let's not give me nothing,
Brady. Brady fades back. Sits tight. Drops way back. Gets it off. Allen is down after making a great play to come down with the interception.
First down is safe.
Tom Brady gets some heat in the backfield, and you have to believe that it caused this pass to not go where he wanted it to. There's the INT right there.
The pressure was good, but Peter, that was a nice play on the ball.
You got that right, Dan. Great reaction time to snag the ball out of the air like that. Well, this is a great opportunity to bring this game closer before halftime. Let's see if they can make something happen here.
.150 on the game clock. Three wide receivers on the field. McAllister with the ball. No gain on the play.
You gotta love the penetration by the D-line to stop that third down from going anywhere but backwards.
It's third and about 13. They have four receivers in. Takanushi takes the stop in the backfield, and the last two plays have been shut down.
Isaiah Takanushi put the hit on, Dan. This is a pretty good hit on third down. Ooh, nice stop.
Peter, he knew how that play was developing. He positioned himself perfectly to do the job. A well-designed defensive play.
Absolutely.
Henson comes in to play after a three and out.
We'll see what they do with it.
Right. 3 seconds left. Brady pays back. Keeps dropping back. Gets it off. It's intercepted. Dodges a tackle. That will do it for the first half. The score, 7-0. Time to go to the ESPN halftime update with Clark Dishman.
Welcome to the ESPN Halftime Update. Now let's take a look at how the numbers break down from the first half. The Lions come into halftime congratulating their defense for shutting down the run. Impressive so far, and a safe bet to be impressive in the second half. Bobby Engram has up to now caught passes for a total of 116 yards and one touchdown. A clear choice for our ESPN Hot at the Half player. That will do it for now. I'm Clark Dishman reminding you to tune in to ESPN's postgame show at the conclusion of the game. Let's send you back to Dan and Peter.
Start up at the 20.
Well, this game could go either way, Dan, and that's what makes this drive critical. They'd love to put some points on the board right here.
First and 10. Brady from the gun drops way back, throws. The pass is incomplete.
Bill Green put the clamps down on that play all by his lonesome.
Right.
Ball on the 20.
Second and long, it's gonna be third and long.
Brady from shotgun keeps dropping back, throws.
Sends a telegram to his man for the completion. Take a look. There's the throw right to him.
This passing offense spends so much time in practice running plays and patterns that it's almost instinctive at this point. Ball at the 35-yard line. Brady from the gun drops way back. Where's he going? Throws. The pass is incomplete.
Neil Ward is there for the QB across the middle, but the catch doesn't pan out.
Second and 10.
Take it down the middle, baby. Yeah.
They have two receivers in. Brady drops back. Sits in the pocket. Hits it off.
This throw is simply amazing. He throws his baby all the way downfield. Look at this moonshot. Unbelievable.
Not only the arm strength is impressive, but to be that accurate that far downfield is nothing short of fantastic.
Right.
Lions, after the big pass last play, will have a first down. Mealy lines up off right tackle. We'll see if he can step up. And again, throws. Was the intended receiver on that play incomplete? Peter, let's back up a play and talk about that completion. That was a nice pass.
Oh, of course, Dan. That was a quality throw. Tom Brady was MVP of Super Bowl 36. The same year, he broke the Patriots' single-season record for pass completions with 63.9%. Man, he's also set a record for the most pass attempts to start a career without an interception. That's 162 straight passes before the pick.
Barely gets it off.
Trevor Price. Well, Dan, that's a great job of getting in and getting a lick on the quarterback to make the errant pass. Close to a sack, but they've got to be happy with the incompletion.
Third and 10.
That's if they want it. Just give it up.
Brady from the gun. Drops way back. Throws. It's tipped. Incomplete, and that's three in a row.
The defense dug their trenches and hunkered down. Just a great job repelling the assault on third down.
Five. Vinatieri lines up for the field goal.
Frankly, I didn't think he had enough power on it. Let's take a look.
Wow,
that almost hit the crossbars. A good kick, though.
That kick just managed to skim the top of the crossbar and count.
Yeah, I think he's just trying to make the game a little more suspenseful, that's all.
The Lions make it a two-score game. They are now up 10-0. Vinatieri will kick this one away. Great kick. Henry will field it. And he will decide to down it.
This is an important drive, Dan. Although there's time left in the game to catch up. If they wait too long, it'll be very, very difficult.
It's first and 10. McAllister will run it. Great move. Stewart hijacks that play after a couple of yards.
Took the handoff and went right of center and picked up a handful.
7 yards to go.
Ball at the 23-yard line. They line up in the eye. Room on the left side. A nice run to the outside. Yields good yardage and the first down.
First down. 10 yards to go.
Ball on the 32. McAllister again gets it. It's free. Payne makes the hit.
Second down.
Deuce McAllister lets loose with an incredible move here. Let's get a better look. Oh, not today.
No way.
He goes for the juice and leaves the defender in the dust.
Incredible agility to free himself up, Peter. An excellent run. It's second and two.
It's second and two, baby. Watch the run.
The Saints will stay with the ball. And seven around the corner and picks up the first.
Carried this one off his left guard. He got some nice yards. More importantly, however, he moves the chains. Nice play.
It's first and 10. What's that? Throws. Flag down on the play. Let's get the call.
Pass interference. Number 32. Defense. First down.
Jason Sehorn has to go for the ball. He can't just manhandle the receiver like that. That's interference.
The Saints will have the first down off the penalty. Sehorn gets set after committing the penalty. McAllister with the carry. Gain of seven.
Well, with the draw between the left guard and tackle, not a bad pickup. Just some nice yards there.
3 yards to go.
Ball at the 41-yard line. McAllister. Good tackle by the third-year man out of Lenoir Ryan.
Took this one off his right guard, but it didn't open up like he wanted it to, and he stopped pretty quickly. This one left gets a little contact, but still manages to keep his feet moving and plow ahead for the first.
It's the end of the third quarter. The Lions' defense is held and the offense has put up the points. So they lead 10-0. The Saints backed up their fourth first down on this drive. They're moving the ball very well. The Saints again. On Ohoppin comes up with the stop, his third this afternoon.
Picks up a few there. It may not look like much, Dan, but getting those early yards makes second and third downs immensely easier.
Ball on the 35. They line up with two tight ends. Ballard fades back. Throws. Stiff arm.
Brett Favre with the completion.
Brett Favre had no trouble zinging that one past the defender, Dan. Perfect throw. He couldn't help but catch it.
The ball was sent there. Special delivery.
And the receiver didn't even have to sign for it.
Ball at the 27-yard line.
Yards there off the first down play, and that really opens things up a bit for this next one.
2 yards to go.
It's second and two. Third and short coming up. Third and one. They go with the I formation. Ball fades back. Close. They bring up fourth and short.
Kevin Dyson couldn't make that catch happen. The ball was a little to his right, I think, and he didn't compensate enough.
It'll be a 35-yard attempt.
Todd Peterson nails it for three. Great kick. It's all about focus.
Without question, Peter. You know, he's got a... The Saints cut into the lead, and the game can go anywhere from here. The score, 10-3. Peterson lines up for the onside kick. Kick is up. Saturday taps it off the bottom. Special team squad.
They would definitely like to score on this drive right here. There's not enough time left for mistakes.
First and ten. From shotgun, throws, caught in the flat. Madison bangs him down after a handful of yards. Ball on the 47. Tight end is lined up left side. Throws. That will bring up third down.
Well, I'm not sure whose fault it is there, but these guys We're way off the script. It's all about focus.
It's third and five.
McAllister was open to the outside, but he couldn't make the catch.
It looks like they're going for it on fourth and five.
Dedrick Ward was the man in the middle on that play. Watch this. Oh, great catch.
Yeah, and very, very tough to do in double coverage like that.
Yeah, you got two guys flipping a coin to see who's going to cream you. Terrific job by the receiver.
All on the 23. Barr, right back, throws, incomplete.
Jason Seahorn with some great coverage on that one, Dan. Played him just tight enough to make it a difficult catch.
Second and 10. Fades back. Goes. Tips. That will bring up third and long.
Brett Favre maybe should have thought twice before throwing into double coverage. That could have easily been picked off.
Third and 10. They line up in the shotgun. One shotgun. Throws. Tackling, but he passed the marker. Big third and long conversion. Ball at the 12-yard line. Four wide receivers on the field. Throws. He's taken down, and that's his third reception of the day. Ball on the three. One shotgun. Throws.
Will Romanowski made the play. Let's look at this again and check out the interception. This is great defense. Oh, nice.
Peter, fabulous timing. There wasn't much of a window of opportunity, but he still managed to make that very big play.
Yeah, you can't coach reaction times like that. Well, it's a close game and time is running out. You have to love these situations. This is a... drive here.
First and 10.
Oh, thank you so very much.
They're going with three wideouts. Brady from the go, keeps dropping back, throws, yeah, the flag on the play, let's listen to the call.
Pass interference, number 31, defense, touchdown,
Jason Kraft gets himself into some hot water with that defensive interference call. It's a fine line, but he stepped way over it.
The Lions get a free first down from the defensive penalty.
Kraft
gets set after committing the penalty. Brady drops back, sits in the pocket, throws, pass falls incomplete.
Tom Brady just threw that one into double coverage. Yeah, this guy just rolled the dice on that pass.
Second and 10.
Take it down to nowhere, baby. Yeah.
Brady from shotgun. Oh. Incomplete.
Tom Brady needed to dial that one up a notch, Dan. Didn't quite get there.
Third and 10.
I see this at the 3-yard line. Breaking the first.
They're going with the tight end right. Brady fades back, sits tight, throws, it's dipped. Fourth and long coming up.
Peter Warwick got across the middle but couldn't make the catch.
Jet comes in and will punt it away. The punt. Henry gets the ball.
This is a huge drive. They had a chance to pile up and head into overtime. Hey, it's crunch time, fellas.
All at the 36-yard line. Far from the gun. Far goes up. Miller will get the sack. Last defensive stop. The Saints take their first timeout.
John Miller granted to some resistance, but tore through that blocker like a bulldozer. And then the sack became pretty much inevitable.
He is a very good and tenacious player. If he's only facing one guy, believe me, he'll take him on, whoever it is.
Yeah, you can't coach drive like that.
One minute, 47 seconds to go. They go with one man back. Ball back. Throws. Tip. Is looking for the ball. Ball is incomplete.
Edward Ward couldn't make the catch
catch, although he had gotten himself to a good spot on the outside there.
It's third and about 13. From shotgun. Throws. The Saints will take a timeout. That's their second.
Dedrick Ward makes the catch.
The clock reads 1 minute, 36 seconds. From the gun, throws. The pass is no good, incomplete.
Brett Favre put that ball too far in front of his receiver, giving him basically no chance to catch it.
Ball on the 40. Incomplete. And that's the second incompletion in a row.
Sam Madison was covering the receiver like a wool blanket, baby. He didn't let nothing get through.
Third and 10. Drops back. Yet again, it falls incomplete. That's three in a row, and it will be fourth down.
Nice job by the D to not let him get far and force a fourth down. Great execution.
They're going for the first down on fourth and 10. Shotgun formation. One shotgun. Oh. It's incomplete, and they don't convert on fourth. They will forfeit the ball on down.
Well, this is depressing to watch. He has this ball. Let me rephrase that. He should have had this ball.
Yeah.
Right out of his hands.
And, you know, the worst part about it, Peter, is that they failed to convert on fourth down. This is a costly mistake. Well, Peter, it looks like their last-ditch effort didn't pan out.
Yeah, they had an uphill battle even if they made it. Good try, but better defense.
It's first and 10. Mealy in motion. Brady fades back. Sits in the pocket. Let's see what it is. Ball at the 42-yard line. Brady on the gun. Drops way back. Throws. The first down. The Saints take a timeout. That's their final one.
Nice completion here. Take a look. There's the throw right in between the numbers.
He had them lined up just right, and they connected for a decent gain. A minute, 13 seconds left. Two wide receivers on the field. Brady runs back. It's tight. Just gets it off. Great tackle by the five-year man out of Clemson.
Tulamili had good position in the middle there, but a completion just wasn't in the cards.
Second and 10.
Where they are. Watch them all. That's right, right. All right, right.
Brady from shotgun. Right at the line.
Lorenzo Brumel did a great job rushing the offense there. Never laid a glove on him. Until there.
Yeah, until there when he lays a big glove on the quarterback for the second. It's third and 11.
That's retired. I'm gonna win, baby.
High formation. Keeps dropping down. Incomplete pass.
Tom Brady had the chance to get the ball to his man, but he passed the ball a bit behind him.
Right.
37 seconds to go. Vinatieri lines up for the field goal.
To connect on that kick. Tough break. Oh, this is a huge drive. They have a chance to tie it up and head into overtime. Hey, it's crunch time, fellas.
33 seconds left. From the gun. Throws. The pass is incomplete.
Isaiah Kakavinsky
managed to make sure that he was positioned between the QB and the receiver on that baby. There was no way that was going to be a completion.
All in the 31. Fades back. Sits in the pocket. Throws. Out of the marker. The clock out at the 45-yard line.
First down.
He connects with his receiver with ease, Dan. He sees his man and then airs it out for the completion.
Yeah, they are in sync. They're able to depend on each other as the play on. The clock reads 26. Drops back. It's tight. McAllister was the intended receiver, but the pass is off the mark and falls incomplete.
Brett Favre needs to find his happy place out there, Dan. He's throwing the ball like it's a distance contest.
23 seconds left. They're going with four wide out. Favre fades back. Sits in the pocket. Throws. Down is 72. It's first and 10. The ball and stop the clock.
No gain on the play. Second down. 10 yards to go.
All at the 39-yard line.
Dishman here with the ESPN postgame show. Let's get started. The Lions come away with a 7-point win over the Saints. They now move to 3-1 on the year. The Lions completely arrested the ground game today. Just look at the statistics. Their front four manhandled the line of scrimmage and was a big part in the win. Bobby Engram hauled down passes for a total of 131 yards and one touchdown. He's our ESPN player of the game. And that's all we have for you today. Don't forget to tune in to the weekly wrap-up for this week's scores, highlights, and analysis. I'm Clark Dishman. We'll see you then. It's week six on ESPN. The Lions come into this one with the dubious distinction of being dead last in rushing yards. Their rushing is ranked dead last at number 32 in the league. They will be going up against a team with similar strengths versus the Vikings, who come in with a struggling running game. As a result, they could be in for a long day. To see how it turns out, we'll go to Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe out in Minnesota.
Hello, and it's a great day for football here under the big top at the Hubert H. Humphrey Metrodome. I'm Dan Stevens along with Peter O'Keefe. Peter, who's going to stand out today?
Dan, we've got a couple of the best generals in the league going at it, and it should be quite a chess match. Mike Tice has really put together a quality rushing attack. You know, it's a combination of play calling, talent scouting, and knowing how to motivate his players. On the other side of the field, you have yet another brilliantly coached team. Marty Morenweg knows how to get the most out of his running backs and O-line. They are among the best in the league right now.
You want tail.
They call tail. Tails it is.
The Lions will receive, and we're about to get underway. Cortez will kick it off to start the first half. clock behind this one. Stewart fields it in the end zone. The 15 stops at the 24-yard line.